guys, so I wanted to do something special on this special day of 420. I mean, it's 421 in Japan, but like most of my audience is from States, so it's probably still 420 by the time I upload this. I wanted to talk about the most taboo topic you can talk about in Japan, and yes, that is marijuana, believe it or not. So currently, Japan has like one of the strictest laws regarding marijuana, or like any illicit drug in the developed world. They're like really, really anti-drug, even like anti-prescription drug, just not a drug culture. So this snip from Vice says, Japan is so strict on weed that when Canada legalized it in 2018, the Japanese government warned its citizens abroad not to partake because they would still face consequences upon their return back home. Under Japan's Cannabis Control Act, weed possession can lead up to 5 years in jail, or 7 if there's suspected intent to profit and a potential fine of $18,000. Jail sentences for growing, importing, and exporting weed are 7 years, or up to 10 if there's an intent to profit and a potential fine of up to $27,000. So usually from what I've seen with people who get busted for weed here is that they get caught with it, and then they're booked for a few weeks, and then they usually get like a 5-year probation. It's just like usually like a first strike type thing. But nonetheless, from the people I do know that get busted, it's usually their first offense. So they usually just end up getting probation. So with the probation, they get routinely drug tested, and they're actually not allowed to leave the country for that duration. The legality of marijuana and like seeing a lot of people I know busted for this stuff really brings light to like the disgusting criminal justice system here. Most of the arrests that I've seen and read about are usually the result of a stop and frisk operation. Stop and frisking is disproportionately aimed towards foreigners, so a lot of foreigners get stopped and searched and questioned more often than just a regular Japanese person. I've had it happen to me on multiple occasions because, you know, in my younger days, I was fucking around being a stupid, you know, whatever young people do, right? And I've just been a lucky person from that. For example, back in the day when my husband was just my boyfriend, we would like hang out and drive around all night and just, you know, whatever young people do, right? And then like, it was around maybe like midnight when we were like turning we were at a right turn at a light, and then when we made that turn we got like pulled over, and they were like, do you know why we pulled you over? And we're like, no, because like nothing wrong was happening. But they were like, you made the turn too fast, like, so they assumed that he was like drinking and driving or whatever, so they like breathalyzed him, and then that came back negative, obviously. Don't drink and drive. And then they asked to search the car, and then they found this stick. It was maybe like 3 feet long stick, and they're like, what is this? Like, they were about to like book us over a fucking stick or something. So I had to explain to them that it was a stick to start the car, because the car was having issues with starters, so by using a stick and poking at the starter sometimes, it made the car start. So that's why the stick was in there, but they were like very suspicious of this stick. But yeah, so they searched the rest of the car, didn't find anything. And you know, like, we're all just standing there confused because it's like, why the fuck? Why are we having this encounter right now? And then at the end, they like looked at the back license plate, and I guess there was like a bolt there, and they're like, it's blocking a character, so please get it off. And that was it. But like, their whole tone the whole time was like they were trying to incriminate us, like we did something wrong, when nothing wrong was like happening at all. So, but I bet you they pulled us over assuming that they could bust us for something. And that's usually the occasion and the scenario that I've seen with people who get busted for marijuana possession, is that they get unfairly stopped and frisked, and just, if they weren't otherwise searched, they wouldn't get caught. So back to stop and frisk. I know a lot of people have gone into legal trouble over marijuana. And yes, they're the victims of stop and frisk. And The fucked up thing here is that the laws do not mandate that the police need to have a warrant or even really a reason to search you. They can basically do it to anyone, anytime, for any reason. So this, I would argue, is the number one reason why behind so many people get caught in the first place, because, you know, other than it, like, unfairly searching people, people aren't really gonna get caught with marijuana possession. Weed or cannabis wasn't always illegal in Japan though. So prior to World War II, Japan actually relied and cherished its embrace over hemp because it was a cultural and economic dependence for it, but that was lost. When the U.S. basically wrote their constitution after losing the Second World War, and that made, you know, cannabis illegal to, you know, follow in the footsteps of American or democratic law and order. But nowadays, the U.S. has become increasingly progressive with marijuana, and Japan has yet to address it. So in this sense, old American influence is still influencing Japan's progression. Over the last decades, Japan has been incredibly successful at demonizing marijuana too, calling it a drug, calling its users addicts, and, you know, celebrities that often get into scandals. They're like actual media scandals that happen over celebrities getting caught with marijuana. If they're sent to rehab, like, it's like a whole, like, thing. Like, if, you know, you read about a celebrity who has a heroin addiction and they get sent to rehab, it's something like that. But with marijuana. So famous people are demonized when they're caught, and in the Japanese language and all around tone regarding the topic of marijuana has always been that it's a drug and you have to stay away from it at all costs. And the laws around marijuana here are actually stricter than cocaine here. So you'll be less scrutinized from the eyes of the public and the law for having cocaine than you ever will for marijuana. So there's so much misinformation that goes around with marijuana too. So I was once a teenager, and like any American teenager with their experimental tendencies, I was caught by my parents for having some marijuana in the house. And, you know, my mom did not take it well at all. You know, my dad is just like, okay, you can't be doing this. You know, the typical reaction you would get from an American parent who catches their teenager with marijuana, right? So my mom called me a druggie. And out of curiosity, she even asked how I even do marijuana. So I told her that it's smoked, and it surprised her that marijuana isn't a thing that you inject, because her impression this whole time was that, like, marijuana is like heroin. You, like, inject it through your skin or something. But no, I had to, like, explain to her, like, how it's actually, like, used. So CBD is gaining some traction here in the younger population. I've seen it more and more widely available at, like, vape shops and other stores, which is probably a good sign that there's the societal consensus around marijuana is changing, because now Japanese people can experience the health benefits that marijuana or cannabis in general can provide. And then I guess they have weed marches in Tokyo now, and that's something I didn't really think would ever happen in a million years. So there is hope on a social perspective, but not so much on a political stage. Japan can't even allow, like, scientific research to happen with marijuana to take place, because even though much of the international community is universal on the benefits of marijuana, the scientific or medical community in Japan is lagging in that respect. But here's why it needs to be done. Cancer is like one of the most common ailments a Japanese person will suffice to. The international community mostly agrees that marijuana has a lot of beneficial effects to cancer. You know, you can argue maybe not 100% curing it at all times, but, you know, at least alleviating the secondary effects of cancer, right? The chemotherapy, all the bad things, the bad side effects of chemotherapy or radiation, you know, marijuana can do something for that. That is very important and should be taken into consideration. And with that being said, the first step for Japan as a nation is to acknowledge that and maybe start some independent research to prove that. And it can save lives, money, and health down the long run. And making it legal to the public for free use or not, Japan is falling behind the developmental curve of the world by keeping it old school with laws that they have with marijuana. So the marijuana debate is like one topic of Japan's lack of progression, at least in the social aspect. It's just a big, great example, but obviously this type of thing can be reflected in other progressive issues that Japan just sweeps under the rug or doesn't really talk about. But Japan needs to open up to new ideas to keep up with the progressive world, or they're just gonna fall back. And I don't think they can afford that with their economy already falling back compared to the rest of Asia, who's surpassing them. So what do you guys think? Should Japan legalize marijuana, even at least medically or eventually recreationally? Should they make the current laws and punishment less strict? Let me know your opinion.